You are now listening to 15 Minutes of Fame Radio.
Let's go!
I don't know what happened, man, but I saw the interview with you, and I didn't see it like you took a shot at Tay-Rock, you know, about the whole surf thing. Like, I didn't look at it like that. I think you said, you know, that's his boy. He knows him longer than me. You expect him to rock with him, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Where did it go left?
Check the interview out and see exactly what I said, though.
Where did it go left for you? Because I saw you said something on Twitter, too, so I didn't understand where it went left. Because I didn't see that you actually disrespected him.
Nah, it ain't never go left with me. I don't really give a fuck about T-Rock or none of them niggas. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know why niggas keep bringing these niggas' names up, but these niggas are super fans, and they be, like, obsessed with me. So these niggas always be talking about me, but niggas try to bring it to my side like it's a two-way thing. Nah, it's just all of them niggas just thinking about me. So niggas fake think I did surf. So surf jumping out the window in interviews talking crazy, then I drop a song. Niggas thinking I'm dissing me when I didn't, because they just groupies and just want me to say their name. So then he start jumping out the window, and then Tay Rock starts on blogs with him talking about he choosing sides and jumping out the window too. But
you did say his name in the song, though.
No, I didn't.
You said Sue.
On what song? On what song?
I definitely never
said, yo, bro.
The bar song.
Listen, I said it in the other interview that you just referenced, so you must have seen it.
I seen it, and even in the clip it's there.
That anybody that I never said no fucking Sue name. So that's what I said. And this blog's out today. Maybe you need to get on it, because I'll be on it. I'm locked in. It's in the cut media. He just put up a blog apologizing because he was the same way as you, uninformed. And niggas was doing blogs thinking I said his name, but now niggas know the truth. Niggas that they research like real fans or real people that's a part of the culture is supposed to do before they put out information. And now he put up a new video apologizing, letting people know what really happened. And that's what everybody's going to do. So when they realize that I never said this nigga name, I never mentioned him, and these niggas did a bunch of blogs jumping out the window, this nigga choose sides for a song that I never even said the nigga name in. So that just goes to show these niggas is groupies and on my dick. Now I hear the nigga twittering or throwing all this shit and talking about he won a battle and he bodied me on a song and he just jumping out the window for nothing. That's why I said I'm going to give a nigga a chance to rekindle his statement, because he's probably not aware of what he's doing. He's probably uninformed. A lot of these niggas be uninformed and don't know what the fuck they talking about and just jump out the window. So that's what he did. But now, it's like I always knew he was envious of me. He always wanted to be in my position. So that's why I never was going to become more of a friend with him anyway, because I knew he was envious on the low. And now you clearly could see it, because there was no reason for him to jump in that bag, and he did, though. You know what I'm saying?
He was showing you mad love
about,
up until that, though. I didn't see that
he
coming.
He talking about he won a battle and he bodied me on a song that I wrote. I picked the beat. He had a dumbass beat when he came to the studio that was trash. So I had to pick the beat, and I wrote the hook, because the only thing he could talk about is guns. So that's why I wrote the hook. I got a lot of guns, but I just bought another one. Because all his verses going to have his guns in it. It's not like he's going to be able to sit down and write, and I wanted him to use the verse he already had. So I just know if I threw a hook like that, then most of his verses could fit. But when he went to go do it, it didn't even sound right. So I had to, like, change it around in his verse. I even had to go in the booth and lay parts of his verse as a reference so he can hear how to lay it on beat, because the nigga can't ride the beat right. So that's why that's the best he ever sounded on beat. That I got a lot of guns with me is the best he ever sounded on beat. Any other song that you play, he never sound like that. He might have took some of the tips that I gave him in the studio, but he still don't know how to do it right. That's why he don't know how to ride a beat right. That's the best he ever sounded on beat, because he was in the studio with me. So I dare a nigga say he bodied me on the song when I fucking executive produced the song and got the nigga the best he ever sound. And I just gave the nigga a little baby verse, because it wasn't nothing. I was working on wild shit in the studio and a mixer on that song. That's just some extra shit I just did for the battle rap community. So it's like when niggas be talking, niggas need to get their information straight. Niggas need to get their facts straight. Niggas know I don't lie. I'm not no fake nigga. So everything I say is real and is authentic. So if I say it, it's the truth. Niggas don't gotta go check it or be like, but you did, if I say it, that's what it is. Now, until you figure out the right amount of information to realize that it's the truth, that's on you. But when I say it, it's a fact. I don't got no reason to lie, especially dealing with this dumb, these little niggas in this battle rap shit. Like, lie for what? Like, I don't got no reason to. Like, I'm the truth. Like, this what I bring to the table, and that's why niggas is uncomfortable. Niggas is jumping out the window, tweeting on blogs, niggas want to battle. Everybody screaming my name. And everybody want to battle. Everybody want this. But I thought I lost. I thought I was a loser. I thought I was washed up. I thought I had 06 bars and all of this shit. So much time passed. Why I'm still the center of attention, the most talked about, and could get the biggest bag right now? Like, why then? Why? It don't make no sense to me. Let's deal with real information, man. Look at the views. My face off alone did more numbers than everybody battled this year. It's like, no battle did more than my face off. It's like, stop it. These niggas got to be joking. October 6th, bro, is going down, man. Don't miss it. Tickets is, I don't even know if they sold out, but they selling out fast. So don't miss history, man. And if you can't get a ticket, go to a fight party, a pay-per-view party.
Facts.
Niggas got to witness this shit, man. It's history. And not just me versus Arsenal, but it's a powerhouse card, man.
We can't talk about it, but can't name the names. But goddamn, it's a lot of people on that card, bro.
Yeah,
it's some shit on that card.
It's too many, man. This is going to be a movie, man. Every time I come out, history's going to be made, man. It's going to be a movie. And I just want niggas to know, you don't got to expect none of that shit you expect from other niggas. Like choking and bullshitting and not being prepared. And just know, if y'all niggas think y'all a little smart and think that y'all can watch a battle and see the difference or see what changed or see anything possible that niggas do or whatever, y'all could watch a battle and see that. What makes y'all think a nigga that was doing this shit, that created this shit, that was putting in work before y'all probably even, most of y'all was probably even born? Like, you know what I'm saying? What makes y'all think he can't understand that? I can. I do. I know what to bring to the table, and that nigga did. October 6th, you can't miss it, man. She's going to be crazy. I can't wait. I'm on the edge of my seat, and I'm not excited like him, like, because this is a dream come true. He's smiling ear to ear because he a fan, and he happy to battle me. I'm excited because we're taking it to my city. It's a lot of energy that's going to be in there. All the silly going to be in there that matter. All of the energy is going to be in there. A lot of odds is going to be on battle rap where it's supposed to be. And the game is never going to be the same after October 6th. History is going to be made, and the shit going to be changed. Shit going to be different. Shit going to feel different after that date.
Wow.
So I can't wait, man. I'm excited.
Yeah, I can't wait either, brother. And again, man, hey, I thank you. Even though you wouldn't let me talk too much in the early stage of this interview, it's killing me, bro. But
because you be doing them complex, questions.
It's not complex.
And when you get to one part, it's like one part you'll say I said something or I did something that I ain't do. So before you finish the statement, and I know you got a lot of people listening, and I don't want you to put, they already confused about how to look at me. So I want niggas to see the truth. So before you just throw it back in their mind, I just be wanting to address that shit first and foremost, so I don't even go down that aisle.
Right.
So maybe if we was more on the same page, we'd be able to vibe more, but I just know it's on shaky ground because it's a lot of people hating on me, and the only time I get to respond is when I do shit like this.
I get it.
Much attention.
I got you.
I got a lot to respond about. People want to hear my side of what's going on right now, so that's probably why I'm in this bag, and you're the first person to get access to it.
Yeah, well, you know what? I get it. That's why I won't argue with you, man. That's one thing I don't want to do is going back and forth with you, and I want to make sure you get to say what you want to say. So that's a fact, though.
But one thing we can agree on, man, is I'm for the culture. You say you for the culture, man. You represent the culture.
That's a fact.
You've been in it for the beginning, man. You are OG.
That's
so
a fact.
We both represent the culture, and we both trying to do the best for the culture, and there should be no reason why we should have a problem with each other.
That's a fact.
You should be excited that this energy is back, as you're saying. It's a lot of eyes open. Everything is better, not just for me, but for everybody else that's playing their part right now. So I ain't doing nothing wrong. There's no reason to hate. Niggas need to just... Niggas is willing to accept Jay-Z doing the deal with the NFL and say, we got to wait it out and just see how it play out. But niggas not willing to see how my thing with this battle rap shit play out, and I ain't doing nothing wrong. All I'm doing is just bringing shit to the table, and niggas just want to hate. But that's just how the world works, man. Niggas just gotta. It's like you're gonna have to deal with that because there's billions of people in the world and everybody ain't on the same page. But at the end of the day, what I'm doing is good for the culture. We see the results on October 6th. Like I said, the game ain't never gonna be the same, man. This shit crazy. I'm just thinking about this shit that I'm gonna say to this nigga, man. And this, man, I can't wait.
Well, I can't either, brother. I'll see you there, man.
See you there, boy. All right, bro.
All right, peace.
15 minutes of fame.
You are now listening to 15 Minutes of Fame Radio.
Let's go.